Namaste YouTube, welcome to Cafe Enoma's Mega Music Reaction Fest 2, and we are going to give our reaction to Don't Try Suicide by Queen. I like the title, Don't Try Suicide.
Yeah, I guess the title says it all.
Yeah.
And knowing Queen, the way they write their songs,
yeah,
it definitely is very clear what this one is about. And I guess it will really, really save lives, you know. So this is, for what it's worth, this is a first time single take honest reaction on Cafe Enoma by Kirti and me. We are two counselors, teachers and parents who work from home and also make reactions during our spare time. So we are very happy to be reacting to a song like this. We hope we are right about what the song is about.
Yeah.
Let's get started. Don't Try Suicide by Queen.
1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Yeah.
Straight as you can get.
A great service done by Queen.
This is
a great service done by Queen. I love the title of the song, Don't Try Suicide. I always admire bands, musical bands, which take care of the welfare of the fans, of the people, those who follow them. And it is their duty, it is their responsibility not only to entertain your fans, because your fans are very influenced by the way you are. You have to give them right messages time to time so that they are on the right track, they are on the right path, because they are your audience. They are the ones who made you who you are. So when you give back in this way, it makes a lot of sense. Don't you think bands can only hold on to their fans by doing such things? If the fans got into this and that and everything else and they are so distracted, why would they be watching what they do? So you have to make sure their, you know, welfare and well-being is always maintained. And I like this song. I like the effort that Queen has put in into the song. The collapse coupled with the drums going on at the same time. I love the bass work in this. The bass was doing fabulous job every time when, you know, don't. It was mainly the bass and the drums that were going all for me, and the voice. I like how Queen, you know, incorporates everyone's voices in the chorus, and they all try to sing like the Beatles. They always do this, I think. You know, more often they have almost all the members of the band singing together, which sounds amazing. It sounds like, you know, you're listening to a band completely. The lines of the song were amazing. It discusses in very simple way the reasons why a person commits suicide and what all ways a person commits suicide. In very few words, they covered all of it.
Yeah, and the lines are so interesting and profound at the same time. Don't do it, don't do it, don't try suicide. You know, nobody cares.
Nobody's worth it.
Yeah, nobody gives a damn. You know, when you die, you know, you may think that it will change the world. It doesn't. It only ended your life. So it was very simple language used in the lyrics, but at the same time it makes so much sense, you know, because when do you commit suicide? You have to, if you identify the reasons, as a teacher and counselor, we do know a lot about it and we do read a lot about it because it's always helpful to know.
Yeah.
You know, when do people commit suicide? When they feel they have reached the end of the line, when they've lost all hope, when they've lost all faith, when they've ended a long-term relationship or a relationship in which they gave so much and they didn't get too much in return, that affects them very badly. A divorce, maybe losing someone very close to them, someone else in their family, or someone who they love dying. So there are various reasons. Then, of course, exam results. When you're young, certain things like exam results, bullying, play pivotal factors in someone thinking about ending their life. So if you identify all this, by ending your life, what will you do? That's what Queen is essentially telling their fans, telling the listeners, telling anyone who listens to this song. What essentially are you gaining from doing this? Like, for example, if you eat a meal, we eat to live.
Yeah.
You know, if we do not eat meals for a long time, we'll feel really hungry, which affects our emotional states, which affects everything in our life. We don't drink water, we die. You know, for a period of time, depending on the weather and things like that, we will die. If it's hot, we will die within 2 days maybe, without water. The same way, when you go think about committing suicide, why do you do it? You think, if I commit suicide, it will be the end of my problems? No, it doesn't end your problems. In fact, it will add to the problems of those you leave behind. Even if it's your pet dog, I have seen instances in my counseling room where, because a person committed suicide, a girl, her dog also died after 2 weeks because there was nobody to take care of the dog. She was the one who's to take care of the dog. She had a very nasty breakup and she was abused in that relationship too prior to that. And due to that, she decided to take this step. And later on, her parents came to me for counseling, for help, because they were distraught. And I counseled them for a couple of sessions. I did what I could. And then 2 weeks later, I heard that their dog died. You know, the dog who was taken care of by this girl died. So, you know, it's not that you end your life, everything's good. It's over. You actually leave behind a lot of problems for other people who are in your home, in your life, friend circle, your peers, your family members, your pets, society at large. If you commit suicide, your neighbors' kids and neighbors also get affected. They may think that is the easy way out. Even I should do it. So you're actually setting a bad example, like you correctly said. So great step by Queen. I never knew this song existed.
Yeah.
A great, great request by a patron to request such a song. It's not a very popular song of Queen, I'm sure. Others have probably heard its name at least. But the fact is, what a great song Queen made. It really will save a lot of lives. And I feel blessed as a reactor that we got the opportunity to react to this. Because anyone who's watching this will be aware that Queen also made songs like these. You know, which is, everyone knows Queen is a legendary band. But what they don't know is that they made songs like these. And now I know, you know, she knows, and we all know.
Queen does have so much variety in their catalog. They you know, made music that was different. Every song, if you look at it, the concept behind the song, they are unique. They were different. We did a reaction to Fat Bottom Girls just the last week or so. And that was completely different from what this is about. Whether you talk about the Rhapsody or you talk about any song of Queen, they have been always taking up something unique in their, you know, lyrics, and in a very effective way. When they take up a subject, they try to make as much justice as they can. And one thing I like about British people at large is, you know, there is not so much complexity when they try to give out a message. It's always simple, it's straightforward.
Yeah, actually,
you don't have
true.
To do much. If it is a British show, if it is anything to do with England, you have to know that it is going to be done in a very simple way, which a child also can understand. Yeah. That is their motto, I feel.
You talk about Mind Your Language, the TV
you
show.
You talk about anything, they do it with simplicity.
You talk about the Beatles, you can understand every song
the
of theirs.
The smallest things
in one
they
listen.
Make into art.
Yeah, Queen does have Bohemian Rhapsody, which is a bit on the complex side. But barring that, I think all the other songs of Queen that I have heard are very, very simple to understand. So you hit the nail on the head.
Yeah.
Definitely it must be an English thing. It's
yeah,
must be
it
part of the culture, and that's
keep
great.
It
because
simple. Keep it simple.
It does straight. It does make the message be heard in the way it is supposed to be heard. And it in fact makes it easy to understand and very, very powerful. I love the tune of the song too. It was very simple. It was very powerful. It was beautifully sung. They were, I think, all band members, I think, participated
yeah,
in it,
I think.
Whether it was by contributing musically or vocally. I think all of them were part of it, as we have seen in other Queen songs too.
Yeah.
And again, you mentioned that, which is worth mentioning again. That is why the Beatle mania was so powerful when it happened with the Beatles. And same goes for Queen, same goes for Pink Floyd, same goes for other English bands. What separates them from American bands and Indian bands or any other bands or groups around the world is that, you know, if you talk about Queen, you talk about the Beatles, the way they sing, the way they sing together, the chemistry, you know, the chemistry is so beautiful amongst the band members that you can literally enjoy the music a lot more than when you listen to any other group from any other part of the world. And of course, this is not a general thing. You can't generalize things the way we actually are right now. So sorry about that, but the fact is, we do notice these things, having reacted to thousands of songs by now and heard 10,000 plus songs in my lifetime. You do get an idea that this is how
about
it is.
The clarity of message and the way it is conveyed, I know because we watch a lot of British shows and we know how clear it is. That's why I subscribe.
Yeah, if you enjoyed this reaction, consider subscribing to Enoma, liking this video, and if you have a request for us to react to, check out our Patreon page. The link is in the description of this video. That's it from Cafe Enoma. Thanks for the request. Thanks for watching. Thanks for your time. This is a great song. Powerful message.